and I was able to show today where I really am. A lot of people think that I'm only a striker because I'm doing that since I'm a kid. But look, today that's what I wanted to show. Show up, wrestle, take down, and big ground and pound. And that's how I got the win tonight.
And you were in control, like you say, the whole time. You had him on his back for a long time in the first round. You seemed to anticipate his every move. Did you do your research on your opponent?
Yeah, I watched his fight. Of course, because like I'm watching every opponent before going in. And I just looked that he was like a pro Muay Thai fighter, but I'm doing striking since I'm a kid. I have hundreds of fights between K1, Thai boxing, karate, and everything. So I know striking wouldn't be a problem. I know he had a proper belt as well on the ground. But I was like, hey, I'm doing MMA for only 2 years, but look, I will show you tonight what I'm capable of, even on the ground.
And you had John Cava in your corner. He has said before, you're one of the best strikers he's ever seen. So everyone was really excited to see your fight. How valuable is it working with one of the masters of this sport?
Yeah, with John, everything is so good in Ireland. Like I say, 2 years ago, I never grappled, never wrestled. And look today what I just did. And he said, he was one of the best strikers he ever seen. And you could see tonight, I didn't get punched once. In the first round, I was watching, throw a few leg kicks just to feel if he was checking or not. I hit him as well. When I saw his body kick coming in the second round, I landed a big smack on his head, on him. And then I put the pressure, land the knee, and I was like, hey, what I do? I continue with my strike or I just take him down? And I was like, hey, do you know what? Let's take him down again. And I felt great. I want to thank as well Remy Physiospar, who was my strength and conditioning coach for the 8 months. And of course, my dad. My dad is with me since I'm a child. And he's him and John Kavanagh are the two main, the best coach in the world. And as well, thanks, all the glory to God.
Santiago, your line is now live.
Asael, congratulations on a beautiful performance, sir. Did you think, did you like the stoppage, or do you think the referee could have stopped the fight a bit earlier?
No, I like the stoppage. Like, I felt great. I was like, he will eat a few more shots. I was feeling that he will give up on the choke, or I was thinking as well, or just break and let him stand back up. So I was. But the thing is, like, I was landing big punches, but then John Kavanagh say, don't forget the elbows. And my dad as well was like, elbows. And I heard one dunk in his head. I heard my elbow on his head, on his skull. And I heard the big noise, and I was like, oh, a few more, and the referee would stop. So, yeah, no, he could have stopped it before, when he stopped, or after. I don't really mind, honestly.
And the last thing for me, I see you carry the flag of Algeria and France, and it made me think about Zinedine Zidane. Is Zidane someone who means a lot to you and to the people in Marseille?
Sorry, can you repeat the question, please?
Yeah, so I see you carry the flag of Algeria and France, and it made me think about Zinedine Zidane.
Yes.
Is Zidane someone who means a lot to you and to the people in Marseille?
Yeah, Zinedine Zidane is a huge superstar, and especially to young guy. Like me, I was born in France, grew up in France, but my father is from Algeria, and we are a very proud community. And Zinedine Zidane was a big star, and he's as well from Algeria. And a lot of great sportsmen in France have the double nationality. And so that's why tonight I was very happy to have the boat flag in my hand. France, that I represent France at a high level of K1. Thai boxing and karate, and Algeria, I never had the chance because I was in the French team, but now I can take both, and I'm proud to bring the both in the cage.
Enjoy the victory, sir.
Thank you so much.
Donna?
Yes, congratulations on the victory. Donna Corby here from Ireland. I wanted to ask about the changes you made from your debut. Obviously, the result didn't go your way that time. It went your way this time. Can you talk me through the changes that, that you and John Kavanagh and the rest of the lads worked on in SBG?
Yeah, so my first fight, you know, as I was saying, I'm striking since I'm a kid. And I was like, this is my pro debut. I want to show everyone that I can KO someone. And my mindset was all on the one punch KO. And my goal was to move a lot because I knew he was a wrestler and I wanted to avoid the ground.
Mm-hmm.
But that was the wrong game plan, and that game plan cost me the fight. And so that then for the whole lockdown, I did it with a very close friend of me, Molo, and my little cousin, Abu Bakar, and he's, yeah. What are them? So Molo is a very good wrestler, and Abu Bakar is a very good Thai boxer. So for the whole lockdown, for 3 or 4 months, I could train every day on my wrestling, my kickboxing. So I learned a lot in wrestling. And then in the end of June, I think, yeah, I went back to Ireland and I work a lot with John Kavanagh on my wrestling. Like, we work a lot on that. And I was like, that's what I want to show in my next fight, that I'm capable of wrestle. And that's what I did tonight.
I did want to ask, so you had had quite a bit of time to train in Ireland before this fight to get back to your camp with John Kavanagh and SBG Ireland. You were able to get back a few months ago?
Yeah, I was able to get back a few months ago. I did my whole preparation in Ireland. The last 3 months, I was in Ireland, yeah. I think that was June, July, August, yeah, September. Almost 4 months in Ireland, yeah.
One last question for me. I do want to ask, we've seen a lot now during this lockdown, during this COVID period, in other promotions, fighters will turn right back around and fight again. I know Bellator is finally going to be in France. MMA is finally going to be in France. Is there any chance maybe you might want to, since you finished the fight so early tonight, maybe get a quick turnaround and jump in if one of those fights falls out?
Yeah, of course. If there is a pullout, I will be here. I would never say no to a fight. So why not? Let's see.
Lenny March.
How's it going, man? Congratulations on the win tonight.
Thank you.
On your pro debut, unfortunately, it didn't go you that way, but you bounced back today in impressive fashion. Was that the perfect way to bounce back today?
Sorry, can you repeat the last question?
Yeah, so I'll quickly repeat the question. So on your pro debut, it kind of didn't go your way. You lost a split decision that night, but today you bounced back with a TKO win. Was that the perfect way to bounce back tonight?
Yeah, that was a perfect. Yeah, the perfect thing to bounce back, and very happy with that, yeah.
How satisfied are you with your win?
Very, very happy. I was like, yeah, my mindset going to his fight was really to make him work for the 3 rounds, put him in the red zone, and after the first 2 minutes when I got to clinch the first round, I could hear him, he was breathing heavily. And I was like, yeah, I'm still fresh. And I was landing some big left hand. I had a good head control and I was landing and I could hear him breathe heavily. So I was like, oh, that's going to be a long night for him. That's exactly the fight went on like exactly what I wanted to.
Yeah, it definitely was an impressive performance. As you said, that he wanted to take it to 3 rounds, but it only took you 2 rounds to get him out of the game. So now, Tal, we'll move on to your next one. Now you're back on track and you're on your one fight win streak. When are you looking to get back into the cage?
Anytime. I really want to say thank you to Bellator to give us the opportunity to fight in this really tough time. So hopefully they will organize event before the end of the year. I know there is a show in Paris next week. But I honestly think that it will not be possible for me to fight because it's in 1 week. So I don't think it will be possible, but I'm really looking forward to fighting the next few months. I will be ready. And even now, I'm not injured. I'm ready to go anytime.
Asael, the last question here comes from Stuart over at Grassroots Boxing. His question is, given your debut loss with Bellator, did you feel less pressure going into this fight knowing there would be no crowd at all?
No, I honestly think that didn't change a lot to me because, yeah, no, honestly, the crowd didn't really make a difference. The only thing was I could really hear John Kavanagh and my dad, like, perfectly. That was the only big change. But other than that, when I'm fighting, I'm really focused on myself, my game plan, and what I want to do in the cage. So crowd or not, I don't really pay attention to that.
All right, great. Thank you very much for the time, Asael. Congratulations.
Thank you.